Hi everyone and welcome to the Round 19 edition of the SANFL Recovery Session. I'm John Nankerville and I'm joined by my co-host Phil Herden as we look back at the three games that were played over the weekend. Three sides had the bye there in Norwood, West and Glenelg, but still some great action across the weekend with some, I guess, quite interesting results in respects to the latter and also one big upset there from the games that were played. The first of which was at Woodville Oval with the Eagles taking on South Adelaide, a game which the Eagles always seem to have in their grasp. South Adelaide fought hard for three quarters, stayed in the contest. In the end, the Eagles too good, running over the top in the last quarter to record a big win.
You're right, John. The Eagles did win every quarter, extended their lead out and have swept South Adelaide with all three victories in their games this year. And with the win and the other results, they go into outright third position. The might be a case of winning the battle but losing the war, though. Some concerning injuries. Angus Rowntree, their best and fairest last year. Andrew Anger, their main spearhead. And Matt Appleton with a concussion late. We'll see how that plays out in days to come.
For the Panthers, an improved performance from their game against North Adelaide a fortnight ago, where they lost by 105 points. As I said, they stayed in the game for three quarters. They fought hard, but in the end, overrun. And there's still, you just do feel a bit of a problem with depth there at Noarlunga at the moment in their league team. Wankie had an off day. He had a couple of goals in that third term, but before that, kicked five behinds, which didn't help the Panthers' chances. But in the end, the Eagles too good, and here are the highlights from Woodville.
Drives it up towards centre wing. It's a wobbly old kick though. Didn't favour anyone, but fortunately Crabb ran onto the bounce nicely. Little Caleb Daniel in there trying to get his handball out. Spun around once, twice and holding the ball. And Luke Jarrod will have the free kick and put the Eagles back into attack.
South's rebound from defence was good. The Eagles up to it at the moment as Staple kicks along towards the hot spot. Oh, great Mark Borholm. Did he pull it in? He did. The resting ruckman. Have the Eagles' first shot on goal this afternoon, and he has made no mistake, Mark Borholm. He gets his first, spins back into play. Borholm against Bass in the ruck. Bass got a little touch on this one, but it's Rowntree spinning out, getting it handled to Heath at 50. He runs to 45, drills the kick towards the goal, and drills the goal for the Eagles, Campbell Heath.
So defensive halfback flank, grandstand side. Gefridis squares it back up. That's a terrible kick. It falls for Tom Bilby. He runs into the open goal and bang, I'll make you pay for that, he says. Drills it over the goal umpire's head. South Adelaide's first goal. So the Ginger Ninja. He's only about 5 metres out from the goal line. He has to run around. He goes to play on. He's been tackled. Allman's got him. That has to be holding the ball. And Robbie Fiarchi, what a fiasco that was. Taylor for the Panthers, but this time Parry with a kick inside 50. Looking for Anger. Couldn't take the mark. Nathan Daniel did well to be front and square. Read the crumbs. Went via cross. There's a bit of action on behind the play there. Robbie will get you to keep an eye on that. As Dunstan with some skills around the body. The ball sits up like a cobra and eventually goes through the uprights. Luke Dunstan, a great goal there. So he has to go short where Gotch is just making the outer side of the ground his own at the moment, picking up a lot of possessions out there. But he hasn't got a lot to look forward to. So he goes in, side 50, big fly from Hardigan. Archie runs onto it, weaves around one, dodges around another, snaps across the shoulder, and he snaps truly. Great goal, Roland Archie. That's an opportunist goal for certain. Robbie Fiarchi desperately needed one for South Adelaide there, second. Brooksby with the tap down. Dunstan just barged through. Caleb Daniel had it stolen. It's out in front of Anger. Pops it across the top. Goldsworthy got the arms free. Finds Appleton. It's now with Staple across the top to Lewis. He'll line this up and he'll drill it home. A wonderful goal there to the Eagles. They just kept working, working and working. Jarrod wrapped up, got a handball away, but now it's South Adelaide through Seckel with a driving kick forward, and on the end of that is Michael Wankie. That's a super mark out in front.
Sort of stops and steadies, hand gestures this way, that. He kicks along to the top of the goal square down there. Brooksby at the back, did he pull it in? He did.
Yep.
Big Keegan Brooksby had two Eagles to beat. So Brooksby, 15 out straight in front, kicks the goal for South Adelaide. They get their third. They're still in this contest.
Running in now, it's Hardigan who relieves the pressure, goes short to Vader. Quick to play on, takes them outside defensive 50. Short little kick. Ooh. Oh, big clash of bodies going in there. Powell and Shaw. Ooh. Shaw looks like the eyes are rolling around. In the meantime, Kane's picked it up for the Eagles. Goes short and finds Hall just outside of 50. Short little kick in, finds Dunstan. Runs under the left boot. There's your class act for the day, Luke Dunstan, his third.
Didn't get the handball out on this occasion, but he'll get the free kick. And now he handballs to Caleb Daniel, whose little chip kick looking for Shaw. Oh, good mark by Von Burdo. Touch the class there from the youngster.
A big kick out here in front of Taylor now, leading in the race for the ball. And oh, he's done a very bad injury there. No. It looks like Angus Rowntree's done his knee trying to twist around. In the meantime, Taylor pops it over to Caleb Daniel.
He's all right in terms of consciousness and that, as we said, but it's his knee that appears to be the problem. They've loaded him onto the stretcher, though, Don, and he's sitting up at the moment.
Yeah, it was just, he picked the ball up and he just went to do a little sidestep, and you could see the grimace on his face as his knee just kept going in the one direction. So, look, hopefully it's not too bad. It might be just that sudden pain that's caused him, but it doesn't look too good, and he sort of felt for the knee straight away, seemed to know what he'd done.
Yeah, look, I'm not overly confident, fingers crossed. I mean, he's such a vital player to the Eagles midfield, and he's a terrific young lad as well, and you could just see the ground move underneath him as he tried to push back, and his knee just gave way, and they called for the stretcher as soon as the club doctor, James Illick, went onto the ground. So let's hope it's nothing too bad, but it doesn't look good at this stage.
Daniel comes in board. That was Caleb Daniel again, but Lewis cutting it off. Nice shepherd from Goldsworthy allows Lewis to load up, looking for Ranger, who tiptoe 1, 2, 3. That'll do for me. Oh, and that'll be a 25 straight away. Kyle Hardigan, that's just undisciplined football. That's going to put Andrew Ranger right within goal-scoring distance here if he wasn't before. This Robbie Fiacci should be a lay-down misere for the full forward.
Yeah, look, I don't think Hardigan did that intentionally. I think he genuinely thought it was touched and played on, but you unfortunately have to play to the whistles umpire, and on that occasion, the umpire said it was a mark to Ranger, and he had to obey that. He didn't. He gave away the 25, and this is a certain goal for Ranger.
Yeah, and look, Robbie, you mentioned the wrist there as Ranger sets from point-blank range. He'll pull the trigger and go bang, and that's another goal too. Oh, well, that's the first goal for Andrew Ranger today, but he did hurt his wrist in that second quarter, so he's carrying a little bit of an injury there, but geez, so athletic and acrobatic with the marking, isn't he?
See, South down by just 27. They've got a lot of work to do, but here they go as Vader breaking the tackle. Gave to Cross, to Taylor at half forward. He goes inside 50, and Wonky, big, bustling and strong, marks this one. 35 out, 45 degree angle. I think that was Mick Goddard.
I thought there was an earthquake.
He just about dismantled the bench in the coach's box.
He's not happy, and it's crunch time because it's still that 5-goal margin that it has been all day, but South Adelaide have shifted momentum in their favour.
As 1-5 for the day, Wonky, as he kicks a goal. He's 2-5 now. As we put the pass behind, it doesn't matter what he's done previously, he's kicking goals now for the Panthers.
All happening here at Woodville Oval as we get near towards the 29 and a half minute mark of this quarter, obviously a little bit longer with that stretcher, but Parry now with the tap back, here's a chance, Lewis loads up from just inside 50, the ball's hanging there, Hardigan, but it's all too late, Scott Lewis, his second goal, just one step, bang, deliver, and that's the answer there that the Eagles had been asked the question, Robbie, and there's their response. Hands off to Powell. Inside towards the 50. Solder crashing the pack in front of Archie there. Picked up neatly by Appleton. Ellis Yeoman just weaved his way out of traffic. Finds Lewis with the look away hand pass. Appleton loads up. Here's a chance for the big boys in the goal square. And that's a massive mark there. Mark Borholm. Fantastic mark. So Borholm, after tossing the grass in the air. There's not much breeze to speak of, but the ball has been floating around a bit at that end. As Borholm comes in, and that's a lovely looking kick. And he just sends it through for his second of the day. And the Eagles now just starting to march away, you feel, Robbie. They go to 14-5-89, the Panthers 6-7-43.
It was up in the ruck, one down by Bass. quick kick out of there by Thulis for South Adelaide. Only momentarily though, as Ullman grabs the loose ball, runs inside 50, fires towards the goals and kicks the goal for the Eagles. So at the 11 minute mark of this final term, the Eagles go on their merry way, and the umpire has pinged him holding the ball because he didn't feel he made enough of an opportunity. Probably a correct call in that occasion, as Powell handballs off to Hall, to Lewis. Further afield to Kane. He runs through half forward, about 60 from goal. Chris Kane, long, strong kick to the top of the goals. Fisted away from Staple. He runs on and grabs the Currums. Lee Staple and kicks his third goal of the afternoon. The Eagles break the tie, 16-5-101. South 6-8-44. Well, the ball up was very nice too, might I add, but the bounces have been good on the nice firm turf.
They have indeed. It's now Appleton trying to charge his way, just diving in over the top there was Bass. And he might have just clipped Appleton on the chin there or the nose as he went through. He might have landed on his wrist because that deck's very hard out there. And Matty Appleton, that's bad news for the young fella because he's in a lot of pain, just clutching at the face. And
he might have just, it looked like he just got collected on the way through.
But it
it did. It was quite bizarre how he went down. He laid flat like he was on a stretcher straight away. So and the blood came straight away because the umpires put their hands up. And they're actually calling
for the stretcher.
Because of young Matt Appleton, who took a bit of a knock, we think maybe from South Ruckman Daniel Bass's heel as they were struggling for the ball on the ground. Bass just sort of coming over the top. We think maybe the heel of Bass's boot has taken Appleton in the face. Certainly he did have a bloodied nose there. He's coming off the ground on the stretcher now as we speak. He is all right. He is moving and talking and all those things. He's not out of it. And at one point, as Don Cooper said, it looked like he might even just get up after initial contact. But I think he sort of realised it was a bit more serious than that. So he's coming from the field now. It's probably going to end up at the 25-minute mark of this final quarter. We're probably with this stretcher case, and rightly so, taking it very carefully.
The Eagles just stamping their authority now, moving Salter into the midfield. On the end of the parry tap, he goes with a big barrel, and that's a great mark out in front by Luke Jarrett. He just turns and shows the ball to Jake Vader, says this is what the Burley looks like.
Vader's giving him a clap. Jarrett, he can go forward and take a mark, and he's got a beautiful kick on him. He'll miss this now. You watch.
He'll line up and he will drill it, and the first person he'll run to and walk past is Jake Vader. Luke Jarrett gets his first for the day and just adds to the Eagles' tally.
The second game on Saturday was at Investra Park at Unley, with Sturt hosting North Adelaide. North had beaten Sturt in their previous two encounters this season and were looking to have a win and get themselves back in the race for the minor premiership. But the Double Blues, who have been a bogey side for North in recent seasons, had other ideas. And after a tight first half when North held sway, Sturt took control in the second half and managed to score a three-goal win.
An amazing turnaround, John, from round 12 when North beat them by 76 points. A great second half effort at Unley means that the Double Blues jump to 8th spot. It is their 6th win on the season, and great to see some of the local players as well doing well. Michael Code really coming to the fore as captain with 29 possessions, Hurley 26 and Battersby with 25.
For North Adelaide, disappointment, it probably means no chance for the minor premiership. And after that great win against South Adelaide at Prospect, where they were so dominant, they've lost their last two games, which would not please coach Josh Franco as we head towards the business end of the season. They'll still be there come finals time. They'll still play a big part, but certainly this last fortnight has raised a lot of questions out there at Prospect as we look at the highlights from the game.
Chris, John Hinch giving up probably 3 or 4 inches on big Daniel Stewart down here. He's going to get his work cut out for him today. Michael Code, interestingly enough, going to O'Sullivan, so trying to get that release player, but also very dangerous O'Sullivan as we know around goals.
Thanks, Nider. Kane puts it up towards the goal squares. It's going to bounce through. Oh, boy, a bit of magic from Kane.
Away to the speed of Ryswick. A couple of options went outside and behind Gordon, who's struggling now. He's under pressure. takes her bounce, and then away to Delwood with support from the half-back player. And then his kick inside 50 astray. Double Blues, though. Fumble the ball critically. It comes back to Campbell, and Campbell kicks the goal. His second of the afternoon.
Anderson slipped it back to Greg. He pokes it up towards the scoring zone. Now comes out now towards Stewart. Can he pluck something out of nothing? Certainly can.
George Thring gets enough of his own ball without giving it to him. High around the corner, dangerous kick, and brave from Battersby.
Yep. Does show promise though, there's no question about that. Oh, huge fly down there. Ben Kane. Punch comes from the back. Max Thring leading in the chase for the ball. Needs to spot up Gordon and does. Roosters now holding possession and they should be away.
O'Sullivan down the line. He ran hard, created some space. Kane will chase him. O'Sullivan decides to go long inside forward 50. Target was Archer and he pulled it off. And there's a good angle on this shot at goal from Archer, who makes no mistake. Margin out to 8 points. Hurley with a free kick for the Double Blues, and they all look a little bit tired, the players, after that little passage of play. Down the line he goes. Big Pat at the back, Kurtz. Oh, and the look away was brilliant. Off to Daldig, inside 50 to McIntyre. That combination has been so good for the Double Blues in the last few years. So McIntyre, 1-1 he has this afternoon. Comes in and connects it well. He was happy with the result, straight off the boot. Very confident finish.
Kenga. Killer, I should say. Pinozzo. He's got a number moving over the top for him. Now it's McIntyre. McIntyre closes to 50. Unloads. Double Blues hit the front. 3 goals to Tim McIntyre. Now they need to move it in reasonably quickly because the Double Blues have got two loose men back there now. Can he isolate the free one? He does. In the form of Stewart. And that's going to be 25.
That was a great kick. I think this umpire over-umpired. I said I wasn't going to get into Fleer, but I just did. Wasn't there. He's tripped over his own feet there. After he tripped over his own feet, he gets a 25, and it's going to put him 3 points up.
North Adelaide hit the front by that three-point margin.
Critical ball up this. 25 out, straight in front. Graham flips it over the top. Battersby kicks it goal. The Double Blues. All of a sudden they're out by 10 points.
Now this is starting to get dangerous for North Adelaide. Pumps them up towards the half forward line. Couldn't quite take it there, was Kerridge. Cut off there by Tambling. Now it's with Greenslade. Does the margin go into 16 points? You bet you know it does. Johnny Greenslade, the pride of the Mount Barker Football Club. Here come the Double Blues.
The final game was the standalone Sunday fixture, Port Adelaide taking on Central District in match of the round there at Alberton. The two sides had played some interesting contests earlier in the year, Port Adelaide winning a thriller last time they met at Elizabeth. The Magpies really needed to win to keep their slim finals hopes alive, and while they certainly had their opportunities, in the end Central were far too strong.
Yes, only the thinnest of mathematical possibilities stop Centrals from claiming what will be their 14th straight finals appearance. Really impressed. Brad Symes a standout with over 30 possessions. It was a good team effort. They ran out the third and fourth quarters really well as the Magpies ran out of legs. And that ruck combination of Seb Gielhouse and Ben Dowdell is really coming to the fore.
Disappointing for Port. They've had some highs and lows this year in season 2013. Played some very good football on today. They had their chances, but some inaccurate kicking, and as Phil alluded to, running short on legs late in the game. Just couldn't see them keep track with Central there, and probably will be it for the Magpies in season 2013. But the Dogs could perhaps cause some damage in the top five, as here are the highlights from Alberton.
Boyd, now he gets a kick down to half forward to Callan, and 55 out from goal, could play on, just holds it up. Port Adelaide pushing numbers back into defence, kicked 5 goals last week, in really good form, goes in short, finds Symes. Symes now gets plenty of the footy, The McGarry medalist from last year kicks long to the goal square. This could go all the way for a goal. It has. It's bounced straight through.
Long kick towards Pry. Gray comes in the window here. Pry keeps well. Gray gets him eventually, though. Was he holding the ball? Yes, he was. Long kick, long stretch, strong run. Good work by Jenner. Hand pass back to Thomas. Edge of the centre square. Thomas has the luxury of a bounce. Runs up to 50. He's got a target. And that was all too easy, Hardy. And who got 25. A shove in the back afterwards. And can't miss territory, would you say, Daryl?
Well, I've already marked it down,
mate. Yeah, I've marked it.
No problem there. So Hardy's going to come in from the goal square, point blank range, and go bang. And he has kicked his first, and the Doggies have got their second. So they go to two straight, leading point 81 behind.
55 metres out from goal. The next kick will be important. Goes to the goal square. Beard sets himself. The big man, he's taken a mark.
And he has taken the mark. He's going to go back from 25 metres out directly in front. And he has guided it through. So Port Adelaide on the board. They go to one goal, 1-7. They trail Central's two straight.
Third, fourth man up. Went to Summerton. To Gray. Long kick inside 50. Reynolds sets himself. Couldn't hold ground. Pryor should have taken the mark and didn't. Spills out. Knee to Thurgood. Open goal. Back ends. And he delivers. Two in a minute to the Magpies. Ends up with hand passes from Harvill back to Dutschke. Now we're Williams, 70 metres out. Strong, confident kick to the top of the goal square where Thomas lurks. Couldn't quite pick up the ball.
Oh, well done.
Place to beat. He drew them all. That left O'Hara open. And you're not going to get a simpler goal than that.
Thought you got ahead of things a bit there, Phil. The kick in goes short. Oh, that's a poor kick in. Good work there by Dowdell over the top. He's given it back though, the big man Slattery. He's fallen over. The Dogs have got another chance. Can the ball come out to Dutschke? Hands and knees stuff. It spills out. Thomas off the ground. He's kicked it. I tell you what, there was a comedy of errors there, Daryl. First of all, the kick out from fullback was chopped off there by Dowdell, and somehow it's come out to Paul Thomas. He's kicked his second goal. Short little kick. And finds the big man in Dowdell. I tell you what, he's played a good game so far, the big man.
He
goes in there looking for Gouels. Oh, he's up! Come on, have a look at that for a mark.
But they're actually doing all the attacking here, the Doggies, too.
They are. Gilhouse, the ruck to Thomas. Here comes the snap around the body.
It's kicked. He's kicked.
It's there! Thomas has his second, courtesy of the ruck work of Seb Gilhouse.
Goodrum in the centre of the ground. They're away on the members' side of the ground. But Johansson's coming in off the line here. He's going to take it. The Magpies are away here.
Here we go.
He can run all the way. He's had two bounces. The young guy's had three. He goes in short to Thurgood. That was smart stuff there by Johansson.
So Thurgood from about 40 metres out directly in front. The breeze at his back will kick from around about 35 metres. Sorry, in he comes now. The kick is on its way, and gee, he's just snuck it in, I reckon. He has. He's got his second, and he's got his third, and Port Adelaide have got their fifth.
As the Dowdell gets the tap down, O'Hara trying to break free. Now Pryor, the kick around the body won't be a goal. We'll land about 2 metres out. Spills to Glenn, and Glenn says, thank you very much. In the midst of being tackled, got foot on the boot. Boot on the footy, I should say.
So Dowdell goes up and down, couldn't tap the footy. Good work there by Koshiel, the big fella. Gives it off there to Newton. Newton at centre-half forward, kicks it long to the goal square. Gray up against Schiller.
Or
it could go all the way. Why not do that instead? And great work there by Newton. Comes down to Waldhutter and also Hoskin. Hoskin wins out on that one-on-one duel. Over there to Jakey Need. The kick will need to be an important one. He's got no one to kick the footy to. That's a smart kick. Centering ball there to Newton. The top there to Young. Young can run all the way. Decides to kick long. Gray sets himself up. He goes. And takes a hang. Great work there by the Magpies.
So he certainly shouldn't have any problem, but will he come back now? And he's done it. So Gray has got his second, and the Magpies just hang in there at the moment.
Up against that boundary line. He'll go with a long boot into the Burley. Glenn lurks at the back of the pack, thumped by the Magpies. Hand pass to the running O'Hara. Gets the low, grab a shot. Will it bounce through? It does!
So what now? 70 metres out from goal. Kicks it long. Thurgood sets himself and takes the mark.
O'Hara and Symes almost fought over it. Symes emerges. Kick outside the centre wing. Pack will set. Good mark. Rocky Wazza.
Plays on quickly. He's got Symes out in his own. The Dogs have got some numbers on the outer side. The Gilhouse can go over the top there to Pryor. Now, Pryor's got 50 metres clear in front of him. Decides to kick it quickly. Down looking for Dutchgear half forward. Scanlon falls over. Dutchgear, if he can hold the ball and play, he does. He plays on. He can run to the goal square. Dutchgear has a shot on goal and he's kicked it. Great work there by the Dogs. The switch of play. They use the numbers well.
Thomas's hand pass out. Now, what can the Doggies do with it? It's inside 50. Callan at the front of the pack. Strong hands, can't take the mark. Could get the hand pass out to Goodrum. Goodrum, the snap on goal. Oh, some great teamwork by two of the veterans. And I think Central's have steadied now. They're starting to use the breeze well.
Rekawaza takes the mark. Hamble over the top is put Watt under pressure. Back to Rekawaza though. They're using the running link up handball. Gives it to Scanlon. Now they can make something happen here, the Magpies. Handball over the top there to Thurgood. Thurgood a long way from goal, but the kick's gone to the centre and finds Newton
mark
at the top of the 50. The Magpies can't afford Centrals to get another goal here in this situation. Ball spinning back into play. Gilhouse taps the ball over the back. Comes to O'Hara around the corner. He's put it through for a goal.
Yes,
that is another set play, Darryl. How many times have they done that today? 70 metres out from goal. He's a thumping kick of the football, though. Kicks it to the goal square. Hable's there, one out against Scanlon. Comes down front centre. Hable's kicked it off his toe. Somehow it's dribbled through for a goal. Unbelievable stuff.
Goodrum
again.
Gets a thump. It's inside forward 50 for the Bulldogs. Dutchke running hard at it. Gets some open space. Has a snap towards the top of the square. Hardy can't take
it. Oh, he's done
it
again!
On the ground by Hable. He's got the double.
Back-to-back goals to Hable. Again, the kick came in quickly.
Someone an end-over kick over half-back Bid. Works his opponent under the ball, but there was Symes. Again, without an opponent. Picks it up. Runs to 70. Someone take a mark inside 50. This time can't happen. Potter. Archie, hand pass to Callanan. He gets it on to O'Hara. Open goal. This'll do it! That'll do it. O'Hara has four.
Towards Johansson. Johansson down the line looking for Beard. Oh, that's a good contested mark, Darryl. Potter for the Dogs. Handballs it over, but Port Adelaide have chopped it off. Comes to something around the corner to the goal square. Oh, great work there by Sam Gray. Roving work. Picked the pocket of the Dogs and kicks his third goal of the game.
Across to Thomas on the half-forward flank. Free player at the 50-metre arc. That's Williams. No one in front of him. He lines up the open goals, goes towards the goal square.
Oh, good mark.
Bulldog mark.
Great mark. And he's going to be going around the corner. One of those
Stevie
J's kicks.
We've got four players on the mark. Hardy wheels around. And if it wasn't over before, it certainly is now.
Just missed.
Kirkwood wasting no time to Madden. Henry Slattery tackled. Madden goes to mop up. He's tackled. Here's the turnover. Harville's got it from Grain. Grain Matong goes with a long kick and seals another one. And just like they have in many quarters in the time on period, the Doggies have dominated. Out of side where Callanan picks it up. He somehow magically gets past all opponents. Kicks it to the hot spot. Dutchke takes the mark.
And he will kick his second goal, and Dutchke's gone back and kicked two.
Yes, a good win to the Dogs there at Alberton. That's our look at the three games from this week. It would be remiss of me not to congratulate West Adelaide, though, for their Foxtel Cup win earlier in the week. A great performance by Andy Collins and his team. It was a funny sort of a game, Phil, but West Adelaide getting the job done by 4 points.
You're right about that, John. A real strange one to watch. West Adelaide dominated the first half, and then East Fremantle could not kick a goal to save themselves in that second half, falling short by just a few behinds. Well, under the Bloods, 100,000 is the winner, and great to see an SANFL team prevailing in this competition.
Foxtel Cup growing in strength each season. It'll be interesting to see what SANFL teams will take part in it in 2014. But that's our look at round 19. Hope you enjoyed the program, and we'll be back next week with the recovery session.